Welcome to Politics Watch. This is Sir P. Now, it looks like the Jamaican government has finally found a pair of cojones. Or they did have some before, but them get a little bigger. Because we're now hearing that the government has decided that regardless of what going with the new strain, kind of, let me say, big C and its strain of them, regardless of what going with the new strain or numbers, them not going to shut down back schools, right, the face-to-face thing in a school. They might go ahead with them plans to make the pick of them, right, physically, right, go to school. For once, let me say, they might show us that they might have some cojones. This decision should have been made a long time ago. Never talk about it. Before we go any further, I want to send a special Patreon birthday shout-out to Sharon, a.k.a. Mrs. Brody. No, you know it's coming straight from my husband already, right? He wanted me to make sure, say, you know, say, him love you and cherish you until that your big day. So, it sounds like he have something planned for you, right? So, I'm not telling the details, I'm not wanting the details, right? But it sounds exciting, so hopefully you have fun, right? Enjoy on yourself, live long and prosper, right? So, big up yourself, Sharon. Depending on them, we could talk about it. When the whole big C thing go on, right, and the government of Jamaica decides, say, you know, they're going to shut down the whole country, and to be fair, the whole world, they did it at the time. Everybody has shut down everything. But we know that's not sustainable. We know say, some things, some industries, some, you know, some fields, just too important for, you know, shut down completely like that. So, one of the first things the Jamaican government opened back was the tourism industry, as expected. Contrary to what you may believe or feel, tourist industry contribution to the Jamaican economy is too significant for them locked down the hotel them for a period of time. So you didn't have to tell me, say, right, them not go up by the hotel them. It's just too important for lockdown. But the face-to-face thing in our schools. The fact that it only get to this stage. No, January 2021, them finally start to let open up the rest of the schools them. In my opinion, that's way too late, but I guess better late than never. Them should have treat education and schools the same way them treat the tourism industry. They should have come to the conclusion, say, we understand that there are risks. We understand, say, it's not ideal, but it's too important for shutdown. The people should have gone back to school a long time, face to face. The online thing, it not go work. We know say no feuds, right? No, have no laptop, and who have laptop now no Wi-Fi, and who have Wi-Fi now have this and who not have this and have that. We know that. Especially youths them from certain parts of rural Jamaica. We know their education has been impacted negatively because of the big C. Pitney should have gone back to school long time. But as I say, better late than never, right? And now when I heard the numbers were spiking, I was thinking to myself, alright, them are going to use the numbers spike, get afraid, and then shut down about the place. This is all enough to understand. Big C now going away. We have to get used to the big C. We have to go live with the big C. Right? Just like how them not find no cure for the common cold, them not find no cure for the flu, them, we just live with it and go on as a society and just take steps for avoidance. That's how we have to treat the big C. Just take steps for avoidance, but this whole people shut down and stay a yard and picnic and go to school. It's not sustainable. Jamaican children are in no position for staying yard. Never shown you some numbers. You know, people talk about big school and what top school. But this time, you know, let me check the numbers again. I was looking at the year 2018 to 2019 because, right, correct me if I'm wrong, but that was the last full term before, right, the big C job. Because big C job really bought the first part of 2020, so I don't even think the school year they done in 2020. But anyway, I'm looking at 2018 numbers then. I'm looking at the schools then, right, that are performing to the standard where I would consider to be good to excellent. When we look on the list, there's about 160 schools, right, and I'm taking this off a site near My Island, Jamaica. You can search it for yourself, right? My Island, Jamaica, and then high schools in Jamaica. You can see the numbers for yourself. Now, there's about 160 How much does that? 161 schools on the list the year before. So we're going to assume, say, at the same 161, right, in 2018 or 19, because school does disappear. Out of that 160 odd number, there are only 32 institutions where 70% of the students pass 5 CXCs and more. You can see it on your screen. I'm not even going to go on at 70%, because on the side, I'm sure you're down to 50%. But in my opinion, right, 50% it's passed, but come on, 50%. And even the 50% figure, 45 schools. 45 schools have 50% or more of them students pass 5 subjects, including maths and English. Then you see them those 2 ones are key. So that means that over 100 schools in Jamaica cannot push out 50% of them students, right, who are past 5 subjects or more. Hope you understand the magnitude. And this is before Big C. Because people want to make it sound like, since the Big C dropped, the children and the schools are so way behind and the schools are going to be underperforming. See, what we can't have happening is people making it sound like, since the Big C dropped, that's, you know, the schools them and the education system, you know, has been basically, let's just call it what it is, mediocre. A long time, right? The results them look mediocre. Long time. Even before the Big C drop. Only 32 schools have 70%. Never show one of the schools them. If you want to see the rest of the one them on the met list, you can go check it out on the site at myislandjamaica.com. But when I look at the numbers, this is troubling to me, because this is simply not good enough. But we can start with the usual high performers. You don't have to ask, because everybody should know by now. The two schools them will battle back and forth between one and two spot. Campion and Immaculate. 1 year Immaculate, next year Campion. St. Andrew High School, always up there. Hampton, always up there. Excellent institution. Knox College, no surprise there. 97% of them students. Mount Alvernia, very, very underrated school. 97%. Not only that, look at the jump they make. 2016, they were 15. 2017, they were 18th. And by 2018, they were 6th. 15, 18, 6th. They're doing something right at that school. We need to ask them. Right, very good school though, ever since. Knox College, same thing. Glenmure, I mean, when I have to tell them about Glenmure, consistent high performer. Montego Bay High School, they might be in a very acidic part of Jamaica, but that school, high performers. Now, I don't have to tell you about Woolmer's girls and boys, right? You already know Woolmer's girls, and especially Woolmer's boys. You know they're going to be there, right? This year, for this particular year, the girls them outperformed the boys them, but you know the two Woolmer's them are going to be there. So those are the top 10. What you have are the 90% schools. Yes. The school you may see underlined in red, right? I've read everything up from this, so is a 90% school too. St. Hugh's, St. Hilda's, York Castle, Mannings, Holy Childhood High, Manchester High, Arden High. These are 90% plus schools. Very, very high performers. The blue line, everything we see up, are 80% schools. Westwood, barely missing 90%. Bishop Gibson, barely missing 90%. Monroe, St. Diego, right? Alpha, Queens, Georges, Belmont, the Cartridge, KC, barely make it over the blue line. Underneath also, you have Morant B. High, Herbert Morrison, Merle Grove, Denby, and Millerbrook finish out the list. As them say in the cartoon, that's all, folks. That's all. It's 60% and under from that point on. A lot of the schools them that are traditionally high performers, what happened is they make them name back in the day, but nowadays they really go out nothing. But because they make them name from a long time, they still have a big reputation. But, numbers in the lie, these are the schools that are performing to a very, very high standards. And it changed back and forth from year to year. So I'm going to say, well, this is from 2018. Still, 32 schools out of 160 odd. And even when I carry the 50%, it's still only 45 schools. They put them in for school. They put them in face to face. Matter of fact, they put them might have to live at the school. The setback of a big C give them, you might have to give the pitting them a sleeping bag, toothbrush, toothpaste, then rag, then soap, and then go and flip at them school. Bed, sleep, eat, cook, and everything at them school. So, I'm glad the government decided. So, again, this is what they must say. Whenever we talk about politicians, we have to be very careful because you know for them more than them action sometimes different. But they say, they now go backtrack and they now go say, stay here because cases arise. So based on what them say so far, big move. They must have to show some cojones. But trust me, Jamaican children cannot afford to stay home any longer. They should have gone to school a long time. The government should look upon it, the cycle them look upon tourism and say, I understand what I said, I understand say it's risky, I understand say, you know, this is gonna happen and that might happen and that might happen. But in life it's all about risk and reward. It's all about pros and cons. And the pros are to putting them physically being in school outweigh the cons. Most children, even if they catch the big C, generally, right, of course, we're not trying to pay a doctor, but most young people, right, with no underlying conditions generally survive the big C. So it's not like say, oh my God, pit never wipe out and dead by the millions. That was not the case, and it was never the case, right? So, you understand all the risks, but you get them off to go to school. So, if for this move, you have to say, right, finally government, right, I show some cojones. Should have done a long time. Long, long time. But, better late than never. Jamaica's education system, Jamaica's schools are underperforming. This is very, very mediocre. But, there's always room for improvement, and, right, them said, I'm bringing new system and make a state work. But these numbers we are seeing, so these amount of schools, right, we're talking about 5, 6 years or so. We're not talking about 7 and 8 and 10 and 15. We're talking about 5, including maths and English. So, we have a long way to go. So, if they pick them start work at school and then they start hearing the news that, you know, 3 people at this school catch big C and 3 people at that school catch big C. We know y'all the, you know, the captain in hindsight, them all come out and say, see, that's why them shouldn't bother my opinion back to ensure locked on the whole thing. I disagree, but that's just my opinion. Right? But as me say, big C now go nowhere. Right. It have a day of probably as long as, right, we've just like your barn comes to flu and barn comes to cold, or probably so from this point on, everybody go just barn come know the big C. So pick them off to go to school. And if you go just stop them in time cases rise and send them back when they go low and start them again, send them back, start them again. That's complete rubbish. Anyway, these are just the opinions of a little YouTuber. You can have your own. Patreon squad, big up on yourself. Yeah, you don't know, more life. Vulture squad, stay circling. Bless.